we go over this simple effect of dialectic. How can we play with the language? And that's a little bit what I will try to present here. I know it's a little bit a provocation. It's not Arabic, it's Farsi. I have a Iranian graphic designer in the studio, and she every time controlled me to don't write Arabic but Farsi. I try also. But when you see a public space, and I take also my own work, often you find this multilingual situation of welcome, and then it's finished. After you go in English. And the point is, how can you deal with this? You go in English, so that's the next panel, or you go in pictogram. And pictogram is also a kind of globish language. Who is not absolutely globish is the same as English. Any can speak English, other cannot speak English. I have some very beautiful pictures about wrong used pictograms in the world, so it's a code. But the point who interests me and why I really work about multilingual situation is that we have a world with 6,800 language, and each language has a culture behind her. It's not only a way to express, it's a medical, it's a world of why you have some perceptions and all. And the point is, all 10 years, 240 of this language take. So what happened with our future lingual, our future world, and how can we work to give the because at all we make nothing other as credibilization. As designer we make credibilization. And we can't, that's the right thing what you say before. You bring some effects in a culture. And we have this capacity out of the business to bring effects and to bring fascination and to bring new element. And the point for me, the challenge is how can we bring again the pleasure not of the large language, there are fools, but also of the minorities. How can we make that Armenian still important language in Lebanon? How can we, I make a workshop in Beirut and we analyze the SMS of the student. And they are so beautiful because they really make Texas in three languages, French, English, and Arabic. And this culture of playing with language is, I think, very more interesting as the culture of translation. Is how can we have this capacity to change language, because in this language, this means not absolutely the same as in the other language. You present all pictures, I represent all that. What is interesting was the Latin was not there. And there are not so many places where the Latin don't exist. So you have really to look. Mostly you find one of the language are Latin. This was one of the most unpopular poster of the Agri Congress in Barcelona, in Sao Paulo. That's one of my students who uses Marco Mayon. And he takes all the language of Brazil. That's the language of the minorities of Brazil. And many of these languages are late. And this one minority is not from Portuguese, but from Earl Cup come from the persons who was in this country before. And this means this plurality we had before. And I'm interested about it. But I'm also interested about elements who make that we think different. We have just to analyze calendars. Calendars are something absolutely beautiful. When you compare calendars from one culture to the other, you understand how deep our culture is, how deep our differences also are, and how interesting these systems are. At all, at the beginning, many things was the same, but the evolution was different. We have the Chinese culture who live, who was existing 3,000 years without fans. Without fans. Culture without fans. But you cannot imagine this today. Today they use fans like we do it also. 3,000 years they don't use files to make our orientation. They construct the orientation with north, with relation, with absolutely other element as to say it's this way. So this means that the so large differences we can have from one to another. This calendar page is a kind of exercise with the of the 60s, I think, who speak about very different kind of also we are in 2010 in one culture, but in your culture you are not in 2010. In China's also not. So how can we mix these very more fundamental differences who are the time, the orientation, and other elements, as also the pictures. We make some analysis of old Chinese books. And when I say we, the research we do in Switzerland about China, and we find out, this looks very simple and normal, but why is typeface here oriented on the base? Why element? And when you start to really understand the systems, you find out subtlety and then using of these characters absolutely different as what we do in our country. And this is one example is to say you can represent a map with four directions. It's not everything. This mean the same time and direction, but also one time in the year, the summer. And you construct your picture about the center and what are around you. We have a perspective. So it's absolutely changing the way to understand and to read this element. One of the most so you see this house and this is a house to give a direction a time in the year. So you can understand mountain in at this time you can go at this place. Another situation, this very simple graphic. You see signs, but you see signs who are in other directions, all other. And when you analyze what really is, you have a construction of a distinction from the king, the emperor. All these elements are present in this graphic design. So the using of typeface make more as only say. This means this, this means this, this means this. And this is the capacity was China because they work with big kind of ideograms and not about this abstract alphabet we have in that. So you can understand all this. The second part, this is also a work of a student of me. And he made a very interesting analysis about the word to say one color. So vocabulary you have in colors from one language to the other. And he made a compare, and you see you have many, you have differences. That's for language. And this language don't mean the same colors. And you have many more, I suppose you have many more words in Arabic to say sand, colors, and colors. So all this is adapted from the context. But this means at all that we don't feel the same colors. We don't, when somebody say red, I think it's okay. But when we start to go in details, we absolutely don't understand the same elements. And that's, I think, this is for four countries with four different vocabulary of red. It's very interesting. The most complex is the Japanese, because they have not only the colors, but also the materiality behind the colors. It's a vocabulary also. So the point is what you said before, is to say from one, and this is also an analysis from Marco Bayon, from one country to the other country, you have absolutely different expression and you have different style of using the characters. This is a different manifestation we had here in Iran. Pakistan. So the same media, the same language, but absolutely different using of language. And this means that typography is not only is cultural. Typography has something behind with very much as only surely is also connected with other sign expressions and all this. We were starting to make a research about this, but the Swiss don't support this kind of research. We will express this complexity of Arabic culture and not only say it's one culture, it's to express also the difference in between those. That's a class of my gym, my daughter. Yeah. And this class is a normal French young class. You have 24 language of parents. The parents speak 24 language. Yeah, you have a father who speaks Spanish, the mother Italian, Balinese. So you have a possibility of 24 language in one class. This is a richness when you can make the culture of this richness. And we start to look with some pedagogue about how can we, because if 4 or 5 years the children learn everything in the quickest time. And we know to learn good, I don't learn English before 5. Learn a language correctly, you have to learn it, you have to hear it before 5 minutes. So, what we start to mobilize is to say, okay, we learned this 24 language. We make the culture of this element. And if somebody not has learned it, it's not a problem. That's come after. But they heard it, they mix it, and that's our world. Our world is the interesting part of our world. We just are in doing one project in Switzerland and it's financed from a foundation about plurilingual language in Switzerland, but we are big conflict because they think behind the brewery equality is things of four language of Switzerland. And when we do this, every time they say, yes, but it's not what we mean about bilingualism. So it's a kind of provocation to say we try really to introduce all the language of the persons who are present in this country. The project will be in six places. We'll make a mix of this language, of this local languages, but also on the situation of the place, on the persons who live at this place. The idea is an adaptation, is to say, yes, sure, you come in a country and in a place, there are one language. And then there are the chaos around. Similar place for each language. And then the third experiences, and I don't have the visual experience, was to say, okay, we make a reduction with absolutely cultural, and we forget this way to speak about these persons, or to give the language, we say, you can do the newspaper, you choose the topic, you choose, and you make one novel. This was an absolutely fantastic experience about this element. But you have all the situation of multilingual. You have the situation of tourism, who you have to explain something not only for the persons on the place. You have these places who are symbolically international, like the Red Cross, or symbolically international, like some cultural places. We walk very early about this way to mix language in a kind of identity and to give a new openness of this place. Or Cité Internationale Universitaire is a place who is a federal place, different countries have houses to invite her students to Paris. And her, we make a work about mixing, it is an old work, so I will not speak a lot about this, about mixing science and give an identity who gives this visit. This was before all this fascination. This was in the 90s. And we do this with something like with different and later or at this day, at this time somebody would know it. Okay. And the idea was how can we introduce some persons was but mostly when they see my conference was very critical about this project because they say yes but it's not translucent and all this. I can only say that many persons who live there say to me, oh yes, I was so happy that one sign was from my cultural systems. And often when you are in a foreign country, you absolutely don't see your culture. This can be a beginning. I don't say it's absolute. We just work on the and this also to say this point of multilingual is from time to time with the neighbors. It's not every time very fair way. And I think the German and the French are going a little bit more two ways. And I was invited to make a corporate design identity for manifestation. The French was invited in the book next year in Frankfurt, and we decided to make a cultural connection. So to not speak about France, to current language and to start to work about this connection. The manifestation will be in other cities, and the point is to say, to explain, to give the feeling about this differences. I like this one. I don't know, how do you see this going in Egypt? Milu is Milu. In Japan, it's Stupi.
No, in Japan, mostly
Stupi. Stupi, in Japan. But how can you understand Tanzan if you have a Stupi and not a Milu? So it's impossible. And this is the point of traduction or not traduction. You have the same animal, like Cocorico in French and KP in German. So is it really the same animal? And these cultural elements are so interesting. I'm so glad to make this project this next year about what is not traduced, what can you not traduce with untraduced people, what are poets using in this other language when they will say something special, know this kind of element. So I try, it's not easy to say everything will be constructed about this this dialectic. And because we are in the 21st century, most of these elements will be you don't have to correct me. So how can you make an identity which is not based on repetition of the same, but is based on this connection on two language and a way to say this is really, really a challenge, because also the cultural persons are so in a deep way to see the possibilities of what graphic design can do other as repeat the same. That is really
this is part time to time and
extremely
how many times I will present you. Because of it's not very multilingual, it's a little bit monolingual project in most invention, was further up in the cultural capital, and we decided to make texts who go around all the city. 10 kilometers of texts. And the city of Mons has many famous poets, and one of the most famous was not from Mons, but was in prison in Mons, Zwerling. And yeah, we speak about all this. And to do this, we use the garage, the typeface who you can adapt as the reality of the urban reality. And this was a little tool to develop all this. First, it was very important to do it as handmade, to bring this calligraphy inside of the city, and also the expression of work inside of the city. And then we start. So this is feel very, very easy. A door was called. But before you had to make categorizations of 400 proprietary accept to that we can write on this building. And at first was not so, they was not so happy. Then we make a prototype in one street, and then was more. And so, and we become 90% positive reactions. And then we have to decide next from the each place. And then we have three graphic designers to make 1 year work on different places. And all this was an absolutely great fest of poetry. So the people use this poetical sentence and make element like this, try to make composition. And at the end of the year, we had to break everything, to break everything up. The proprietary say us, no, it's absolutely, we will not. So we had really problems to bring it up, because it was really something who was accepted from the population. Because it was war, because we use 1 year, it's not just a manifestation, it will go because of this, all of this. At all, for me, the topic of how can we give again the rights of the population, of the right. It's for me a very big. And I see graphic designers from time to time as affectionate, because they work on affection. And we have to accept again unperfect typography. We have to accept that the population has the right to express himself on the street and on posters. Other. We made an analysis of a little city in France, 8,000 inhabitants, who was found. And the city named Necropolis, we look at everything who was writing in the city, everything, because it's not so large. We can we make a picture from each element, we can analyze why this element is here, who was the author, who, why this form at this place, from whose order is it coming, is this Loi, is this corporate design Loi, or other elements. And at the end we find out that 99% of what is right in the city is out of the place. Is not worked on the place anymore. It's prefabricated, it's ordered, dictated, and all this. So we decide with the mayor of this little city to give a new Loi, to say this city, you can make every site you will, the city will accept it, but you have to do it. You have to do it at the place. You cannot do it outside of the city. This changed everything. So we had to start. This was the first prototype. We have a bullshit house, and on this house, every time was posters, but only the rich can pay the poster, and we decided to say the program of the week will be every time white. And for this, we need calligraphy. So we ask students, children, old persons who are time, and they start to write. And each week was different. This was the pose. This is a famous calligrapher, so we had specialists do this, and then was testing, and more they had this capacity. This one. And more, I speak about jardiner l'espace public. Jardiner is garden as a public space, because garden is a little bit same as learning typhus. At first, you are not good, and than you. Any are better, others are not so, feel it's not so good, but you have the capacity to learn it. And we have to guard it, the cities, make it more beautiful, more interesting, more floral. This was on the city house. Maybe in French, on the city house, you have to write Liberté, Égalité, Fraternité, but on this city hall, it wasn't right. And I see this, and I make an SMS at the mayor and say, we have to really intervene on your facade. He say, yes, okay. And I make the layout very quick, send it also in an email, and the afternoon we was in painting. And this kind of project I like, because I have other projects that need 3 years to finish one authorization to do something. So, but it is for a time, you can change it after. And the idea is to say, can every time we, this was the swimming pool, and then was election, and the mayor don't win the next election. So the story is finished. This means next summer we will go again. Yeah. Ah, this was so after I think we will be on the house. I understand that I speak too long, so I can't speak and come from this position. We have a kind of universal attitude, and we think that this is understanding from every person. I was in Africa, and I see this very beautiful panel on an airport. I don't say the city, but on the lounge, and transfer. So this is just here to understand that pictograms are a language and you have to learn it like another language. It's not better, it's not harder. It's probably a little bit more easy to learn it, but you have to learn it. It's not universal and it's very occidental. And any element like this for me was every time confusion. Is this toilets or is this something else? And we try in the airport of Paris, it's a project of subway in Paris, to work on this situation to say we have to explain more because you have elements to go down, elements to go up, you have to know the destination, you have to understand elements. That's also examples of language was also a project in Switzerland to use other languages as Swiss language. And the drawings are from a Chinese student, one of my Chinese students, because you need from time to time also to have another language to see, or other eyes to see elements. Make a portrait of Switzerland from the Chinese point of view. So I come now to this last project. This is a future subway in Paris. Paris is in the moment in a problematic dimension of reading the maps but there are big force who say this is perfect and we don't have to change the autos. What is interesting in this job is that we go over the border of Paris. Paris has a very mental map who is very fixed on the old dimension of Paris, and you see the different maps of this of the subway, these maps of subway are total construction of metadata. When you have a map, you understand more or less London, New York. New York is very easy. And what you see here is very long. You had this insight, and after they couldn't do it. After it's watching. And we are in order to make a new line, new subway line. You go. This is Paris, and this is the large Paris. The first subway line who will connect the different lines, because before everything was radial from the center to outside. And so I think the challenge is to say, forget this Paris of 2.1 million inhabitants and start to speak about the 12 million inhabitants of the Grand Paris. And we think to be a motor of this very, very difficult. You are in different communes, and these communes still not the same way. You have an absolutely different kind of social conditions. Our proposal is to say we have to express these new connections, and you have to express this new surface, of course, this new position. And the best way to do it is with the same and with this construction. And when you see the radial construction, you see that all these lines will be connected. But what is also interesting when you do this at all, you can give the time. And in this time, this schema, you can be very more easy as in the map. You need 52 minutes to go from one point to the other, more suit to north of Paris. In, with the new subway, you will need something like 30 minutes. So this, the distance will not be the same as the time. So you have to make a representation of time and a representation of distance. And what we see is that every information will be in the now we are with five most used information. So will be not this is for me a big challenge to say you can make system with a very, very complex system with five language and not with two and not with one. And you can, and I think that's the end of my expose. After this, you have the new challenge of mapping in element you have with you. You have big, big new problems of science systems, but that's not the topic of today.